So what steps could we take to ensure that there's fresh, clean, living water available for future generations? And this could be one of the most crucial questions to the survival of the human race and, in fact, you know, nature as we know it. Some of the most amazing work has been done recently in regenerating landscapes because rainforests produce rain. In areas where the big scrub or the rainforest has been cleared in the past, there's people who've started permaculture or food forest projects and have found that once they've planted up those paddocks and there's rainforest, that springs that used to be there have now risen again and have come to the surface. And the work of a forester called Victor Schreiber in Austria in the 40s and 50s talked a lot about this, about water as a living being likes to come up in the shade. And so once we cut the forest, it drives these springs underground. So the single most important thing we can do to ensure water for future generations would be the cultivation of forests. And they could be food forests, timber forests, wild habitat, but it's bringing more forests back, and those forests will stabilize our water cycles. And of course, in the landscape, even when it's raining, they act as a giant filter and sponge. So they'll hold the water in the landscape, and they also filter the water and bring it back to life. So this becomes vital.